Hello friends, welcome to Slide Hunt with C programming video tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm gonna show you how to pass the address of a variable to a function, and it is called pass by reference. So let's begin. Here we first create two variables and assign some value to these variables. Then we create a function that takes the address of these two variables as a parameter and print the value stored in the address that we have passed. So first create here two integer type variable, int a which is assigned to 30 and int b which is assigned to 50. Then we print the value of the variable a and b. So I am gonna write here printf a equal to %d and b equal to %d and give here a slash n and we refer a and b. Next we need to call a function and pass the address of these two variables. So I am gonna write here swap and then write ampersand a and ampersand b. Ampersand a means address of a and ampersand b means address of b. Next we need to define this function. So write here void swap and as a parameter it takes two integer pointer. So write here int star x and in star y. To declare a pointer variable, first write star and then variable name. Here star x and star y are two pointers. You think why I use here pointer variables instead of a normal variable? Because here we pass the address of the variable a and b. A normal variable cannot hold the address of another variable, but a pointer variable can hold the address of another variable. That's why we use here pointer variable instead of a normal variable. Now we print the value of the variable whose address is pointed by the two pointers x and y. So I am gonna write here printf %d, then give some space and then %d in slash n, and here we refer star x and star y. Next we do the prototyping. Write here void then function name that is swap and it take the parameter as pointer of type integer. So I am gonna write here int star and then int star. Let's check the output, compile it and run it. As you can see here it print a equal to 30 and b equal to 50 because here we assign a equal to 30 and b equal to 50. Then it print 30 and 50. Because using swap function we pass the address of the variable a and b and here we print the value stored in that address or memory location. Let's see how it works. Suppose this is a computer memory. A is stored in one memory location, b is stored in some other memory location. We assume that a is stored in memory location 21375 and b is stored in memory location 21376. When we call the swap function and pass the address of the variable a and b, then the variable x and y hold the address of the variable a and b. X hold the address of a means 21375 and y hold the address of b means 21376. When we print that value in the printf function, star x indicates the value stored in the memory location 21375, that is 30, and star y indicates the value stored in the memory location 21376 means 50. That's why it print 30 and 50. Now in the swap function we exchange or swap the values pointed by these two pointer x and y. To do the swapping we need a temporary variable, so I am gonna declare here int temp. Next we copy the value pointed by the pointer x to the variable temp. So write here temp equal to star x, then copy the value pointed by star y to star x. So write here star x equal to star y, then star y equal to temp. These three statements swap the values pointed by the pointer x and y. Here we are not swapping the value of x and y. This x and y containing some memory address. So we are swapping the value stored in that memory location. Let's see how it works. To do the swapping, we first write the statement temp equal to star x. X contains some memory location. that is 21375, and star X indicate the value stored in the memory location 21375, that is 30. So now temp containing 30. Next we write the statement star X equal to star Y. Star Y indicate the value stored in the memory location 21376, that is 50, which is copied to star X. So now star X contain 50. Star X indicates the value stored in the memory location 21375. So now A contain the value 50, and then star Y equal to temp. Temp containing 30, which is copied to star Y. Star Y indicates the value stored in the memory location 21376, that is this memory location. So now B contain 30. You can see here the value has been swapped. Let's move to the coding. When swapping function finishes its execution, control returns back to the main function. Next we print the value of A and B after this function call. So I am going to copy it and paste here, and I am going to write here after function call, and write here before function call. Let's check the output, compile it and run it. As you can see here, it print before function call A equal to 30 and B equal to 50, because here we assign A equal to 30 and B equal to 50. Next we call the swap function and pass the address of A and B. Inside the swap function, we just print the value of the address pointed by the pointer X and Y. X hold the address of A and Y hold address of B. That's why it print 30 and 50. Next we swap the value stored in the variable A and B using these three statements. When swap function finishes its execution, control returns back to the main function, and then execute this printf statement and print after function call A equal to 50 and B equal to 30. Because the value has changed in the swap function, and the change is reflected to the main function also. That's why it print after function call A equal to 50 and B equal to 30. The last thing that I must say, using pass by value, we can return only one value at a time. But using pass by reference, we can return more than one value at a time. This is the advantage of pass by reference over pass by value. That's it. Hope you understand. See you in next tutorial. Thank you for watching this video. To watch more videos, please subscribe this channel.